Hey guys, welcome to SS Unitech. Sushil this side, and this is continuation of SQL Server project. So in the last video, we have seen how we can check the login credentials. So the data in the table is encrypted. So we have seen how we can check the first time login for the user, and after that we have checked for the login details. So today we are going to check if user is going to login the first time, then it will ask to change the password. So how we can write the SP, and that SP will be going to help us for update the password in the table. So go to on the SQL Server and we'll try to create that SP. So here, as we can see, we are having this login details table. So in this table, we are having business entity ID, login ID, then login hash value. So this is the encrypted value. Then we are having the password that is also encrypted, and we are having the flag. So basically the flag is going to indicate this user did not login anytime. So once it will be going to login, so this password will be going to update and this flag value should be update. So we need to write the SP. So how we can write that? So basically it will be going to have two input parameters. So let me call this SP as sproc update password. And it will be going to have two parameters. So first parameter will be login ID, and this is varchar 100, and then the password. So this password again will be varchar 100. Then we can put this as, then we can have this begin, and in between we need to write the code. So first what we need to check, so we need to check if your new password is same as existing password, then we need to reflect the flag value as 0. If your new password is not the same password, then you need to update that. So first let me declare a variable, declare at the rate flag, and this should be integer, and by default we can put this as 0. So here what we can do, we can check if exist select 1, then from our table, that is login details, where we need to check for the login ID. So here we have login ID H value, and here we can check for the password equals to. So it is having at the rate login ID, which will be the input parameter, and for the password it is also having the input parameter. So either we can decrypt this or we can encrypt this. So let me try to decrypt this. So if you have remember how we can do the decrypt, so we can use the decrypt by pass parse. Then we need to specify the hash key value, and after that this login ID. So if you have remember, the hash key value is SS Unitech. So it seems good, but we need to do the cast this value as varchar max. The same thing that we need to do for the password as well. So we can use the decrypt by pass parse, and here we can specify SS Unitech and then put comma, then after this put the bracket as varchar, and it should be max. And here we can use the cast. So here if the existing password is the new password, then we need to return inside the flag. So we can have the flag value. So at the rate flag, we can set on this as 0. So which is the by default value. And then we can use the go to option with SSU. And below of that we can have SSU like this. So this is, if this is not the case, if your new password is not the same one, so what we need to do, so on that scenario we need to do the update statement. So we can use the update set and where clause. So in the update we can have the login details, and in the where clause it should be going to have the login ID
hash value is equals to login ID, like this. So for this, either we can directly copy this code from here and try to put it here. We need to update the password, so equals to @ password, but we need to do the encrypt on this password. So what we can do, we can use the encrypt by pass parse. Then we need to specify the hash value, that is SS UNITEC, and after that we can close the bracket. Second, we need to update the flag value. So this flag value is equals to flag value plus 1, but before going to update this, we need to check the null on this flag. If that is null, then we can use the 0. We can remove this, and below of this SSU we can select this flag value. So select @ flag as status. So what it means, basically, if we are going to check this flag value, if that value is 0, so we can have this as 1. So by default it is 1. If we are going to see if the existing value is same as new value, then we are going to set this as 0, otherwise it is 1. So by this flag value we could see the status inside the API. If we are getting 1, so it means the data is updated successfully. If we are getting 0, it means the existing value is the same one which is the new value, so that we can directly return in the API. So user can directly see, and after that they can update the password after making little bit modification on the password. So this SP will be going to help us on this scenario. So I hope guys you have understand how we can create this update password SP. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. And if you need this SP, so I will try to put this on the description of this video, so you can directly copy from there. See you in the next video with new project.